The country town of Gyeongju is located 360 kilometers southeast of Seoul, the capital of Korea. Gyeongju was the capital of the ancient Silla Kingdom, which lasted for nearly 1,000 years between the 6th century BC and the 10th century AD. The Silla Kingdom, founded in 57 BC, was the strongest among the three kingdoms that arose on the Korean peninsula, and finally in the 7th century, it unified the country, annexing Goguryeo to the north and Baekje in the west. Silla thus emerged as the center for the government, economy, and culture, and created a rich cultural heritage. Even today, historic remains abound in Gyeongju. The Pulguksa Temple, with exquisite sakya and abundant treasures pagodas. The impressive Seokguram Cave Temple. An astronomical observatory, the oldest in the world, still extant. Bunhwangsa Pagoda, built of brick-shaped stones. A colossal bronze temple bell dating back to 771 AD. A stone tortoise-shaped base for a memorial tablet. Numerous royal tombs from Silla days constitute another invaluable aspect of the age-old city. In autumn every year, modern Koreans pay tribute to their ancestors in accordance with traditional rituals. Since they believed a dead man would be reborn in another world, the people of Silla furnished the deceased with elaborate burial gifts, including personal ornaments and horse trappings. Such customs have been verified by excavations of ancient Silla tombs. A cluster of tumuli around the tomb of King Michu in downtown Gyeongju. This tomb is called Tomb of the Heavenly Horse. Here we may examine the structure of the tomb. A wooden burial chamber is placed in the center. Stones were heaped on top of it and then covered with a huge earth mound. Silla tumuli, therefore, are classified as cairns with wooden chambers. The tomb excavated in 1973 was named the Tomb of the Heavenly Horse because of the discovery of an equestrian mudguard decorated with the painting of a heavenly horse. Among the burial trappings uncovered were a gold crown, gorgeous jewelry, and various kinds of daily utensils. With the dual purpose of studying Silla tombs and erecting an open tomb museum, the northern mound of tomb number 98, a huge tumulus consisting of two mounds, was excavated in 1974. The tumulus, presumably dating back as early as the 5th century, has a diameter of 120 meters and a height of 23 meters. During 13 months, some 16,000 tons of earth were removed as the first step for clearing the mound. The excavation started on the 6th of July, 1973. earth was removed to a point 11 meters above the ground level, and from then on, only the central portion of the mound was dug out. As the earth was being removed, a layer of clay was found extending from the southern mound, an important fact which evidences that the southern mound was built earlier than this one. It took nearly 1 year to reach the stone layer covering the wooden chamber. The layer was 17 meters beneath the top of the mound. A makeshift structure was built above the stone layer in order to carry on all weather excavation work. The canopy was of great help for preserving and examining relics uncovered by shielding them from wind and direct sunlight. The 6.4 meter high stone layer of the mound was found to extend 16 meters to east and west and 12.8 meters to north and south. Unlike other silla tombs, there were holes pegged with thick wooden poles at regular intervals in two rows. There were traces of wooden beams originally used to construct a framework over the burial pit prior to erection of the inner stone mound. A detailed plan was drawn up according to exact measurements of the locations of discovered traces for the beams and the stone mound. The space once occupied by the wooden chamber was found to be sunk in, as the chamber had long since decayed and disappeared. This is the caved-in part. The earth surface survey on top of the mound also verified its existence. The caved-in part, filled with earth, is now excavated, leaving cross-shaped balks. The stone layer, 12.8 meters wide to north and south, and 6.4 meters high from the ground level, contains the caved-in part, 4.6 meters long and 4 meters high. It took 24 days to remove the earth and the stones from this part. The removal of the stone mound started on the 20th of September 1974 as the balk was broken. During the process of removing the stones, there appeared traces of stones that were piled up inside the vanished wooden posts. To prevent any possible accident, the western section of the caved-in part was checked and dug up first. While removing the stones, several red-tinted rocks appeared in the northwestern corner. It was the first time to uncover so many red-painted stones from a single tomb. The details of the excavation work were recorded on the basis of exact measurements and surveys. The use of conveyor belts aided removal of stones more efficiently. The caved-in part was arranged in an orderly manner after 24 days of work. Then the spot where the wooden container had been placed emerged clearly. On the 9th of October 1974, a small piece of pottery, intact in its original position, was excavated in the northwestern corner. On the same day, several gold ornaments were also discovered. It was presumed that they probably were placed on top of the wooden chamber as a last-minute gift to the dead, immediately before the stones were laid down, and had fallen into the bottom of the chamber when it collapsed. Also found with the ornaments were horse trappings adorned with blue wings of a special kind of beetles. The horse trappings were scattered in the southern and southeastern sections of the lair. In the southeastern section, horse bells were also uncovered. The excavation work progressed even on rainy days. The full floor plan of the burial chamber was drawn up on the 14th of October, 1974. A detailed survey revealed that the length of the main axis of the wooden chamber in east-west orientation was 6.8 meters, and the south-north axis 4.6 meters, and the height of the chamber 4 meters. On October the 16th, 1974, a gold cup was found in what could be called a treasure chest placed at the eastern end within a short distance from the head of the deceased. It was the first gold cup excavated from a Silla tomb. On the same day, a silver cup was found in an earthenware pot placed north of the treasure chest. Well protected within the jar, the silver cup was in excellent condition. The burial floor of the tumulus was humid, unlike other tumuli previously excavated. It was covered with a somewhat sticky, dark brownish substance similar to coal tar. Organic materials, aside from wooden pieces of the coffin, probably formed the substance, whose exact components are under scrutiny. All the muddy substance on the floor was carefully filtered two or three times with the aid of water, in order not to miss even a tiny piece of relics. Numerous relics were found by removing the organic material covering the treasure chest. Complete data was recorded, including exact measurements of each relic and the position of its discovery. On the 22nd of October, 1974, excavation of the burial chest was begun, as drawings of the objects in the chest were now complete. A silver girdle pendant and the girdle ornament were uncovered first. They were no longer in their original shape due to corrosion. A silver cup is being lifted from among many silver items beneath the girdle pendants. Odd pieces of gold pendant ornaments were discovered in an iron kettle found in the vicinity. Each pendant consisted of a finial and a suspending chain thread. Another gold cup was found in the chest. So far, four large and eight small gold cups had been excavated. The gold cup first uncovered from within the chest. A silver cup and a vessel uncovered from an earthenware pot. Gold pendant ornaments excavated en masse. Though their usage is not exactly known, their exquisite shapes are noteworthy. The silver cup. The frontal surface and the bottom of the cup executed in relief are decorated with various designs, including those of animals. Corroded silver objects underwent a reduction process by a group of chemists. The silver objects regained their original form and shape after the process. Three incised characters, meaning girdle of the lady, referring undoubtedly to a queen, proved that the northern mound is the tomb of a queen. Late October, the weather became changeable, mostly windy, but the excavation work went on. On the 25th of October, pieces of glass were found in the northwestern section of the chest. Quite unusual compared to other relics, they drew sharp attention of the excavators on the site. The collected glass pieces were either striped or cut of plain green in color. During the process of collecting the glass pieces, a small glazed pottery piece was uncovered from beneath the silver vessel. Earlier, lacquer pieces were found littered in the eastern section of the chest. Although they were badly crushed, various painted designs attested to the high standards of Silla's lacquer artists. Thank you. In the evening, excavators kept busy sorting the relics and planning the schedule for the next day. This small glazed pot was dated to the late 4th or the early 5th century. A glass goblet with brown flower patterns and stripes was also found. Amid burning incense, customary in traditional funeral rites, broken pieces of the wooden coffin cover were carefully lifted. This work was carried out at night to obtain maximum concentration with minimum confusion. The first piece was taken out in the presence of all members of the excavation team. The wooden coffin was covered thickly with viscid materials which were very hard to remove. Gradually, however, the relics began to appear in their exquisite shapes. The relics in the coffin were found preserved in perfect order. The corpse, whose head lay facing eastward, also retained its original shape. The director of the excavation team was interviewed.
박사님, 드디어 찬란한 빛을 발하면서 신라 천년의 신비를 간직했던 금관이 그 모습을 드러냈습니다. 작년에 발굴한 천마천과 비교해서 특징적인 것만 간단히 설명해 주시기 바랍니다.
네, 이 고분에서는 나온 유물이 굉장히 양이 많다. 무슨 금제품이 가게 이렇게 많이 나온 것은 처음 보는 현상입니다. 그런데 보시다시피 이 금관은
Generally speaking, this tomb has more relics than any other one, especially the gold articles. The gold crown is not entirely different from other ones already excavated, but its ornamentations are unique. The girdle and pendants, especially, are distinctive in their size.
그 밑에 이제 요폐 수식이 이제 쭉 많이 달려 있고 발 밑에는 이 장신구, 몸을 장식하는 이런 것이
Various ornaments were found distributed from the waist to the feet. The fact that gold bracelets and rings were used for both hands shows the social status of the buried person.
이 무덤에 묻혀 있는 분의 성질과 그 지위 같은 걸 나타내는 데 충분한 것이고요. 이 요폐가 쭉 여러 개 보입니다만 이것이 유종 상태가 조여서 이 순서를 그대로 원래대로 알 수 있다는 네. 이것도 이분 조사에서는 처음 있는 일입니다.
네. 박사님 그리고 저 이 무덤이 말이죠. 천마청보다 좀 앞서지 않느냐 이런 얘기가 좀 있었는데요.
네. I personally believe this number 98 twin tumulus is older than the tumulus of the heavenly horse excavated in 1973. This one was probably constructed in the early 5th century in view of its structure and the type of relics. Members of the excavation team noted the setting sun glowing especially bright for several days as the gold crown was uncovered. 리포터스 and interested persons visited the site to learn news of the excavation of the gold crown. continued in the presence of these observers. An exact drawing was made according to actual measurements of relics in the coffin. This is the completed plan of the coffin interior. On the 4th of November, The crown and other gold ornaments were removed. Six long and short pendants, believed to have been attached to both sides of the crown, were found beneath it. Gold pendants in the shape of earrings were also found. It has been proved that they were used not only as earrings, but also as ornaments for other parts of the body. Now, bracelets and rings were uncovered. Among the 11 bracelets found were one with small curved jades and another with inlaid glass balls. The number of rings excavated was 12. Next, girdle ornaments were lifted. The girdle was made up of various ornaments and 28 plaques decorated with spangles. The girdle ornaments. Finally, the girdle pendants were excavated. Careful removal revealed their order of suspension. In all, 12 small and one big ornamented girdle pendants were uncovered. The small ones were of different lengths, between 22.5 and 33.5 centimeters, and the big one was 77.5 centimeters. With the large girdle pendant as the last item, all the relics in the coffin were excavated. The gold ornaments uncovered so far weighed 3.75 kilograms in all. Thank you. Apart from personal ornaments, no other relics were found in the coffin. The surfaces of the coffin, decorated with openwork arabesque designs, drew the keen attention of the excavators. The team spent many sleepless nights in excitement, sorting and treating excavated treasures. The gold crown, by the way, has a height of 27.5 centimeters and a weight of 790 grams. The crown has three uprights in the center, ornamented with spangles and curved jades. An antler-shaped upright on each side. And three long pendants attached to either side. The ornaments of this crown, somewhat smaller than others, are far more exquisite and delicate. Among the 11 bracelets excavated, 10 are 7.5 centimeters each in diameter, and the remaining one, used for the left hand, is made of a piece of 2.1 centimeter wide gold plate with inlaid pieces of gems. Among numerous fragments of ornaments found in the coffin, some remind one of those of the style of Koguryo in the northern part of Korea. The girdle and its pendants. The length of the girdle is 120 centimeters and the weight 331 grams. The total weight of the small pendants is 348.5 grams. The big pendants weigh 281 grams. Curved jades of various sizes and shapes, and other ornaments found in the wooden chest. On the 8th of November, a large sword was found on a stone pedestal south of the treasure chest. Three more such swords were found on top of an iron kettle within the chest. From the surrounding space of the chest, earthenware items, including a pedestaled tray, were uncovered. This piece being lifted is a tray made of clay. Keen attention of the members and observers was drawn to spindles for textile equipment, wooden combs, tree leaves, and a piece of hemp cloth. these findings confirmed the deduction that the tumulus is that of a noble lady. A long-necked pot made of bronze. This pot, along with the glazed pot and the brown glass goblet, provides valuable clues to the dating of the tomb. Pottery and pedestaled cups uncovered east of the chest. This wooden board was beneath the burial goods located close to the head of the deceased. Below the wooden board, many brilliant beads were found in their original positions. Investigation revealed that the coffin was made up of an outer and an inner case, and the chest was placed at the eastern tip of the outer coffin. On the 23rd of November, glass beads scattered inside the coffin and a necklace ornamented with glass and gold beads were removed to a container approximating the exact original positions. A long necklace is rearranged as it was originally. Meanwhile, wooden and other organic materials were chemically treated for conservation. Soils were also tested. The timber for the coffin was discovered to be Zilkova wood and that of the chest, chestnut wood. The process of excavation and all the relics were recorded on color slides. The number of plans and drawings of the excavated relics and structures finally exceeded 100. To wind up the excavation work, details of the structure of the tumulus were checked again and studied. As we see here, a stone floor was first built and the wooden coffin was placed on it. A box-shaped wooden chamber was made to cover the coffin, and the chamber was supported by beams. The space between the wooden chamber and the posts was filled with large stones. On the 2nd of December, part of the stone mound was removed to examine the ground below. It was revealed that the northern mound was built by removing part of the northern portion of the southern mound, and the wooden posts were driven 50 centimeters deep into the ground before the stones were erected. The mysteries of a 5th century Silla tumulus have thus been unveiled, including its structure and details of burial objects. In the meantime, excavation of the southern mound is now underway and will be completed by the end of 1975. Then the excavated tumuli will be renovated into an open museum, another cultural gem for the historic city of Gyeongju, the ancient capital of the Silla Kingdom.